What excites me about neuroscience is the fact that the people involved, the energy that's created by the research that's generated through neuroscience is quite tremendous. And really, in the last decade, the breakthroughs that we've learned from neuroscience research about how the brain works, but not just how the brain works, but how drugs of abuse actually interact with the brain, it's something we didn't really know about maybe even a decade ago as much as we know now. As acting deputy director of NIDA, I see a broad array of science that we support through our extramural and intramural program. And really, I think, you know, what's really changed, a game changer in terms of how we think about drug addiction is the sequencing of the human genome, which happened several years ago. With that information now, we're able to really think about the genetic basis of drug addiction, the genetic basis of disease, which we thought about for other diseases like heart disease, cancer, and now we can apply that same technology to our understanding of the diseases of addiction. And where we go from there is, of course, once we find the genes through these large, very large human genome-wide association studies, which have been very fruitful in giving us genes that we think are relevant, we can take those genes and bring them into the laboratory, into what we call animal models, functional genomic studies, to actually look about how these genes affect the brain and how they make the organism vulnerable to drug addictions. Of course, we have much more to do in sort of learning about how these genes affect the brain, how they affect behavior, and ultimately affect the disease of addiction, but we're well on our way to really learning more about the genetics of drug addiction. For many years, we thought addiction was a moral failing. Or if you remember in the 70s, your brain on drugs with the fried egg. We've really come a long way to thinking about the molecular changes, really at the cellular molecular changes of how drugs affect the brain that lead to this complex problem of drug addiction. Addiction is a very complex disorder. We know it involves the brain, and it's a disease of the brain. But it also involves behavior, environmental factors, vulnerability factors, including developmental stage, plays an important role. But really, we've accelerated our research in the neurosciences to the point where we really understand a lot about how the brain changes when exposed to drugs. And we think about addiction as a pathological learning and memory disorder, where drugs of abuse actually change the wiring or the dynamic process of the brain in ways we didn't understand before. So I see over the next few years, we're really going to be accelerating those efforts and understanding new molecular targets that can be used in medications development for treating substance abuse. I see great vistas in understanding how the brain is connected through what we're calling the human connectome, understanding in a very dynamic way how regions of the brain are connected, both under normal conditions, but most importantly, how those connections are changed and significantly changed and to a pathological way that lead to substance use disorder and addiction. So there's really quite promise moving forward when we think about how neuroscience over the next decade will really change how we think about drug addiction, how we conceptualize the problem as a brain disease, but more importantly, how we're able to develop new targets and new medications that can hopefully overcome these changes, these long-term changes that occur when people are exposed to drugs of abuse.